Bush on right now, so if any of you are messaging me on Facebook, I can't reply to you. I'm on another 30-day ban, recovering from a 30-day ban from, I think, 2 weeks ago, and then about a month before that, I was banned for another month. Most of you probably know that I was charged by the state government of Victoria for intending to incite serious ridicule, revulsion, or contempt for Muslim people. I was convicted in magistrate's level of court last year, and currently appealing to a higher level of court. That appeal is in 2 months, in August. I appear briefly in court next month, and then after that I'll be in court again. I have a lawyer, a good lawyer, who's passionate about this. It took me a while to find a good one. But the chances of beating it are looking pretty good. And how ridiculous is it?
We'll be there with you on the day, mate.
Good on you. In the courtroom at magistrates, when I was convicted of intending to ridicule Muslims on Facebook, not a single Muslim was in the courtroom. Not one. There was not one complaint made by any Muslim. The government got offended on behalf of Muslims and then charged me for it. They charged me with intent. That means they went inside through my head and decided that I had offensive thoughts when I posted the video I posted to Facebook. That my thought processes were wrong and I needed to be punished for it. And they got what they wanted. This sets a dangerous precedent in our country. It means that for not what you do, but what you think, you can now be charged and convicted for what you think. I was convicted of a thought crime. The media doesn't want to talk about it. All they want to talk about is the fights that happened between the left and the right outside the courts on the day. They're distracting us. Distracting us from the fact that we're losing not only who we are, but our freedoms as a people. It is so important that we continue to share our pride and the information that we have with our people in this country. Many of them are lost. They have nothing. Nothing but wine and cheese. You can see them as we're marching in here. They're perplexed. They can't believe that people with the national flag are marching through Melbourne. It's astonishing. How is that allowed? They're probably thinking. We must always believe in ourselves, in our country, in the greatness of our history. Never let anyone take it from you, because it lives in you. They can kill us, but our national ideal, our pride, will live on. It's not about hating anyone. In my heart, I have no hate for anyone. I have only love for my people, concern for my country and my culture, who I am. If I were Asian or African, that would be something which would be commendable. I'd be given money by the government to start up an organisation. But because I'm white, it's a crime? Why? Why can't I look out for the interests of my own people? Why is that so wrong? You don't have to hate anyone. You just have to love who you are. There is so much propaganda and misinformation trying to convince you that you have an evil past and you deserve to die. Literally, it's telling you you don't deserve to live because of bad things you've done in history. This is called war propaganda. It makes you believe that you owe something to everyone else. You owe nothing. We owe nothing. We're a great people. We've earned who we are. We've earned this get out of this shithole city.